हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ आशा मैम, फैकल्टी विथ विद्या भारती इंस्टीट्यूशंस. टुडे वी विल डील विद द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स ऑफ द चैप्टर दिस इज जोडीज फॉन ऑफ बुक हनी ड्यू क्लास 7 एनसीईआरटी. सो लेट्स लुक फॉरवर्ड फॉर द क्वेश्चन एंड आंसर्स विथ डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशंस. नाउ वी आर इन पेज नंबर 90, कॉम्प्रिहेंशन चेक, क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. It is saying what had happened to Jodi's father. So the answer is Jodi's father had been bitten by a rattlesnake. Okay, students. Question number 2. How did the doe save Penny's life? So the answer is Jodi's father killed the doe or she deer. He used her heart and liver to draw out the snake's poison. In this way, Doe save Penny's life. So here, students, you got to know the answers that Jodi's father was bitten up by the rattlesnake. So for saving his life, he has killed the she deer and take out his heart and liver so that he take out the snake's poison and can save his life. Okay. Now, the third question asking, why does Jodi want to bring the fawn home? So, the answer is, Jodi's father had killed the doe. Without the mother deer, the fawn was likely to starve to death in the forest. So, Jodi wanted to bring the young fawn home. Okay, students, you got the answers. As Jodi's father has killed the she deer, so without the mother, the fawn would be starved and leads to his death, right? So to save his life and to attribute the obligation that because of her mother, his dad was saved. That's why he brought the fawn from the forest. Okay. Question number 4. How does Jodi know that the fawn is a male? So the answer is the spots on the fawn's body made Jodi know that it was a male. So here, students, the answer is it can be explained as that by looking into the animal's spots, we can find out that whether they are male or female. So Jodi has noticed that the fawn has spots. So, with that, Jodi got to know that the fawn was a male, not a female. So, dear students, question number 1 of page number 91. Jodi did not want Millville with him for 2 reasons. What are they? So, when Jodi and Millville was going together for bringing the fawn from the forest, so in between, Jodi stopped the Millville and he said he wanted to go alone. So there were 2 reasons. So the answer is, Jodi did not want Millville with him for 2 reasons. One reason was that if the fawn was dead or could not be found, he did not want him to see his disappointment. Second reason was that if they found the fawn, then the meeting would be so lovely and sacred that he did not want to share it. So students, these are the 2 reasons because of that Jodi did not want Millville with him. Okay. Question number 2 asking, why was Millville afraid to leave Jodi alone? Answer is, Millville did not want to leave Jodi alone as he was afraid that Jodi could lose his way or get bitten by a snake. So these are the reasons because of this Millville afraid to leave Jodi alone. Now we are in page number 94, comprehension check, question number 1. How did Jodi bring the fawn back home? So the answer is, Jodi picked up the fawn into his arms and proceeded to home. After some distance, he kept the fawn down and took rest. Later on, the fawn followed him, thus he brought the fawn back home. Okay, students, since Jodi himself was a kid, and the fawn has weight also. So with these things, Jodi brought the fawn back home. Question number 2 asking, Judy was filled with emotion after he found the phone. Can you find at least three words or phrases which show how he felt? Of course we can. So let's check out the answer. The three words or phrases that can show how did Jody felt after he found the phone is that the phone looked at him through its watery eyes. As the phone touched Jody, he felt a sense of attachment. Okay. Question number 3 asking, how did the deer drink milk from the gourd? So the answer is, the deer drank the milk from Jody's hands. When Jody gave milk to the fawn in a gourd, it buttered it suddenly, smelling the milk and not knowing what to do with the milk. Then Jody dipped his finger in the milk and pushed them into the fawn's soft wet mouth so that it would drink the milk. Okay students, this way you get to know that the deer was actually the things, the home, the gourd was very new for the fawn. So he was also hesitating that how to drink or what to do with the milk in the gourd. Then Jody helped him drink the milk. Okay. Question number 4 asking, why didn't the fawn follow Jody up the steps as he had, though it would? So the answer is, it is used to a life in the forest. When the fawn reached Jody's home, it didn't follow Jody up the steps because of the strangeness of the house and the steps and everything. So students, here you got to know that Jody was brought the fawn from the forest, and the fawn was used to live in the forest. He used to see the trees, the grasses, the wood. But in the home, Jody's home, the scenery was totally different. It was totally strange to the fawn. So he was little bit confused, and that fawn did not know how to follow the steps. Why did Penny Baxter allow Jody to go find the fawn and raise it? So the answer is, Penny was convinced by Jody's argument that it would be ungrateful if they left the fawn in the forest to starve. He realized that Jody was right, so Penny allowed Jody to find and raise the fawn. Okay, students, so here the answer is saying that the Penny saved himself by killing the doe, the she deer. So it is his or his family's duty to take care of the fawn. That's why he permitted his son Jody to go and find the fawn and raise it. Question number 2 asking, what did Doc Wilson mean when he said nothing in the world ever comes quite free? So the answer is, Doc Wilson meant that Penny must pay back to the doe whom he had killed for his own gain by bringing and raising up her fawn. So students, here it is saying that Doc Wilson is saying that in this world, for everything you have to pay back whatever you do. So since the Penny had killed the doe, so it is their duty only to take care and raise the fawn so that the fawn did not die by starving in the forest. Question number 3 asking, how did Jody look after the fawn after he accepted the responsibility for doing this? So the answer is, after Jody accepted the responsibility for looking after the fawn, he brought the fawn to his home, took it to the kitchen and fed it milk with his hand. So children, Jody was so kind-hearted that he has also fed the fawn his own milk. Question number 4 asking, how does Jody's mother react when she hears that he is going to bring the fawn home? Why does she react in this way? So the answer is, Jody's mother was surprised when she hears that he is going to bring the fawn home. She reacted as while pouring the coffee, she holds the coffee pot in the mid-air. She reacts in this way because she is worried how she will feed the fawn. Okay, students. So here the answer is saying that Jody's mother was little surprised and shocked when she heard this, because Jody himself was a kid. So she thought that she only has to do all the work and took care of the fawn. So she said like this. Okay, dear students, thus we have completed the full question and answers of the chapter. This is Jody's fawn. Hope you have got to know the explanations of the question and answers. So write it in your copy with a clean and neat handwriting and learn it. All the very best for your studies.